Hello everyone, this is Gary from Fantastic Fundas, and in this lecture I will be talking to you about the response of Indians when they got conscience, okay, when there was consciousness about the nationalist movement, right? Now in this lecture, I hope you have listened to the earlier lecture, because if you want to understand and learn this lecture, then you will have to understand the earlier lecture, the one before this. Only then you will be better able to appreciate this one, right? Now, before I proceed with the lecture, I'll just give you the quick overall structure of the lecture so that it will be easier for you to remember, right? I told you about that various things were happening, right? Like, because of which Indians got aware, Indians got this consciousness, Indians were aware, they were having nationalistic attitude that we want to get free of Britishers, and the reasons of those I had discussed with you, right? What happens when you are aware of something that you want to achieve, that Indians had a goal now, or let's say a target now. So what did they do to get this target or achieve this target? So the reactions of Indians over here at this time, that the response of Indians against these exploitative policies, it was multifold response. It was at many levels. I'll talk about all the levels, and then at multiple levels. Now, there was gradual resistance. It did not happen overnight or in one night. It was not possible to happen overnight because of the size, extent, variation, and the number of kind of variety involved of the people, of the culture, language, religion, region. So many factors were there. It was not possible to have just one movement right from the moment go. There was not even realization that we are under the control of the Britishers. Okay, so once there was development of the gradual resistance, and once there was gradual resistance, that slowly took shape of the national movement. And this national movement, this was a very slow movement, or it had to be slow. It cannot be fast for reasons already I just said to you, right? And because of that multicultural, multi-ethnicity, and that, India being a mosaic of tiles, right? Thousands and thousand different things are there. So it was slow, but then important thing is it was firm, pakka, right? It was firm over there. And there are many examples of it, right? What are those examples? That is the topic of our today's lecture, and I'll be discussing these things in detail. What are these things? Number one is the tribal movement are there. I have already done this thing in detail with you in the lecture on tribal movements in India, but here I will be giving you a quick reference of those. I will not go into much detail of this. Then I'll talk to you about the newspapers, so press freedom. So press was another thing. I'll talk to you about this in detail, as I have not talked about this earlier. And then finally, there were many organizations formed, and that was the response of the Indians. I will talk to you about those things also. Okay. So one of the initial things that came up at this time, it was the tribal and the peasant revolt in reaction to the national, in continuation of this realization that British are not for are not for the good of Indians. So just to oppose them, these things will come up, right? Now what happens after this? See, initially whatever these movements are, okay, initially these movements are not nationalistic in character, right? Not nationalistic, especially the tribal movement. And then slowly, they lead to, however, slowly they also lead to national consciousness, right? And that is actually all these organizations also. That is why earlier I said that all these organizations culminated into formation of Indian National Congress. Okay, so there is the feeling of nationalism or nationalistic consciousness formed, right? And then, so if I talk to you now about the tribals over here, these are the three themes of my lecture today. Okay, and please remember, in today's lecture there will be a lot of factual information. Please do not ask me to explain that, because it is a fact. Okay, if you ask me, okay, what is the color of the sun? It is yellow. Now I don't want to give you theory of why it is yellow. Of course that can also be explained, but there is no point of knowing it, understanding it. What will you do with that information? I'll explain you only those facts which are important for the purpose of our exam. It is a highly factual lecture, this one, here onwards. There will be some logic, but that will be very less. It is highly factual. It is history. You can read it from anywhere. But there is a reason that I'm going to discuss here. I could have simply given you the list of the facts, but that list is available everywhere. So what is the point of making these lectures? It is to make you, help you understand and better understand and easy remember and easily recall that all these things in your paper. That is why I'm making all these lectures. Now, let us begin with the topic of the tribals. As I said, I showed you the topic or location of the tribals in our lecture, right? Now, see, all this tribal movement, they had, you know, they believed in fairness. Tribals, aise to hote hain, they are very just people. That is how the tribals are, right? And, you know, they believe in proper order, legal order of the society, okay? And all these things, right, they are based on their traditions and traditional elements. So that is important thing in the tribal, their tradition. And these traditions are there, right? And see, all these tribal movements, that is like one character of tribals. You must understand about what are tribals before you move to understand the what kind of contribution was made by them. Okay, what are tribals? I'll talk to you in the polity lecture. Now, the tribal movements, right, these are essentially tribals are, you know, they live in forest area or jahan par population density is very low. They have traditional way of living. They are not scientifically advanced. So few such things are there, right? Anyway, so all the tribal movements were very violent in nature. That is like one aspect you have to understand. And almost all of them. And it was of, why were they fighting Britishers? Because Britishers were having the policy of social differentiation. Tribals were treated in a very, very poor manner by Britishers. I've done a lecture on tribals. Please do not ask me for much detail in this lecture. If you do not understand tribals today, go and listen to the lecture on tribals and you can come back on this lecture. I'll just give you a superficial detail anyway. So there was social differentiation and then there was social discrimination against the tribals. Okay, they were not given enough, right? So such things were there, right? Now, the possession of the land, right, and possession of land was taken away from them, right? So basically all the tribal movement, they were restorative in character. They wanted the old system of there to be revived, their old culture, their land should be given back to them. Okay, and fifth thing you need to know about tribal is that they only exploited the outsiders. Okay, they were not exploiting the people who were not harmful to them, right? They only they troubled only the exploitative outsiders. That is the thing, right? And then, you know, they had a sense, all of them had a sense of solidarity among themselves, these tribal people over here. That is the characteristic of the tribals generally. Now, and these tribal movements, they actually narrowed down the gap between intelligentsia and popular masses. That also became important. So there was, on one side, there is intelligentsia, okay, intelligentsia, and one side are the tribals, right? So there are two things, and these two things, they got together, you know, with this gap got reduced with these movements. And how did it happen? The best example of this is given in the Neel Darpan. I've already talked to you about this in quite a detail, right? And this was Neel Darpan. This was written by Deen Bandhu Mitra. Okay, Deen Bandhu Mitra. And this was on the indigo farmers, right? And who translated Neel Darpan? This was translated by Michael Madhusudan Dutt. Okay, it's Michael Madhusudan Dutt. He translated this Neel Darpan. Now, there was another, okay, so that is how the things, I'm showing you, intelligentsia tribals were combined together, and that is how people are getting united to fight British, right? There are many rebellions. The first and one of the most important rebellion related to the tribal is that of the Santhal rebellion. As I told you earlier also, this is one question which holds the record for being asked maximum number of times in paper, whether prelim or mains. This has been asked endless number of times. So this was there in 1855 to 56. And why was this rebellion there? It was against the exploitation by the Britishers of the Santhal tribes. Santhal tribe hold one of the largest population in India among the tribes, right? And not just by the Britisher who were exploiting, one were the Britisher, other were the money lenders who would give these people money on loan and the interest rate of which would never be fulfilled. What to say of the principal amount? And they were these were also the people involved. They were known as Dikus. And two important people of this are Sidhu and Kanu. Sidhu, however you want to pronounce that, and then comes Kanu. These are the two important leaders. Even this has been asked. Would Sidhu and Kanu are associated with which rebellion? I mean, come on, this crazy, the kind of question being asked. Just out of this much information and that I have talked in the earlier lecture, all the questions have been asked. Now, they oppose the recruitment of labor, right? And they always invoke their religion, their god was called Thakur, is still called Thakur, and they were against the forced labor, or if I have to put in one word, what is forced labor called? It is called Begar. They were against Begar. And Begar has been forbidden under the constitution of India also, right? So that was like just a very brief thing about the Santhals. And then there came these Indigo revolts, as I said, this Deen Bandhu Mitra was there, okay? So there were some also Indigo revolts, and these revolts were there in Nadia district of Bengal, right? There was just one Bengal at that time. Now, the two main people over here involved were Bishwas brothers, right? One was the Digambar Bishwas and other was Vishnu Bishwas. These were the two main people of this. And this movement was essentially, you know, in the form of the social boycott. Why is this important? Because it was non-violent movement. It was non-violent. Okay. Obviously, we could not have fought Britishers. Had we Indians fought the violent movement. See, if we were very violent, what would have happened? British were much stronger than us. We were fighting with spikes and swords, and they were fighting with guns. Who would have won? Obviously, they could only have won. See, we can actually emotionally talk about it, that we could have done this or that, but the practical ground reality is very different, right? And then there was another movement, right, by Birsa Munda. This is another very popular movement by Birsa Munda, and this was also known as Dharti Aba. Okay, Dharti. I'll just write it again, Dharti Aba. And basically this person was known for his medicinal and healing powers, but ultimately leads to a revolt against the Britishers, right? And they were basically fighting for again the same thing, right? That labor should not be exploited, their culture should not be disturbed, such thing, right? And they have the right to land, itna sara chakkar hai iska land ka. Okay, so there was basically extreme kind of consciousness happening, okay? And ultimately all these things, you know, they lead to a revolt which is known as Ulgulun. And this was in the year 1899, this rebellion. And Ulgulun basically means tumult. Bahut zabardast tumult tha ye yahan pe is time pe, okay? So there was basically this extreme kind of consciousness among the tribals and masses, which would be all this thing. So whatever the tribals do, right? So as I told you that there are tribals, right? And these tribals, they are aided, right? Or let's say they are facilitated by, their consciousness is facilitated by the middle class consciousness. So middle class also makes a rise. Middle class consciousness. This also plays an important role, middle class consciousness, right? Now, just before I talk to you about this, please understand that basically this middle class consciousness, how did it come? It was reflected in few things. For example, it was reflected in the writings, or it was talked about in the articles and the newspapers. Okay, so that is why the UPSC keeps on asking questions about who started this newspaper, who wrote this article, and all that, right? Whatever its history is, okay? So they keep on asking all these things, okay? So now here I'm going to give you the list of the various newspapers that I have compiled from various sources. You can get this list also on internet, on any website that you want, but that will not serve your purpose, I'm telling you. If you really want to learn newspaper, then you will have to remember the newspaper right here with me, you know, that is the best way of remembering. If you want to make notes, you may just make these notes along with me, okay? So I'll just make the chart for you. First of all, let me make this is for the serial number, okay? This is for serial number over here. We'll keep it fixed. And then over here, we will write the name of the newspaper, okay? And after this, we will talk about, you know, who started this newspaper and all, right? So we'll talk about these things over here, who started the newspaper and every detail, right? And other details, okay? So we'll just keep this thing fixed, and then, you know, we'll add few things now to this. So the first newspaper that started at this time, that was the first vernacular newspaper. If you know the name, it was known as the Samachar Darpan. Please understand, there is no other way of remembering these things. There is no time to go into details of this. That will be totally bullshit. All you have to do is remember these things. Slowly, when you spend time with these things, you will remember. When you spend some time with your friends, what happens? Get to know them, okay? Here, what will happen if you keep on seeing these newspapers, their names, who started them, you will eventually be able to recall them in your exam, okay? Now, Samachar Darpan newspaper, right? It was started by, who started it? I'll just write his name. It was started by Joshua Marshman. And second person was William Ward. How to remember this name? I'll try to give you a few hints to that. And because it was the first newspaper and this was the first vernacular, it had to come from outline, some other kind of world. It came from Mars to India, right? And the main, or there was some other organization involved actually for this, which these two people were working. This was known as the Baptist Missionary Society. Okay, and because of their theme of focus on Christianity, initially Hindus were not really in favor of this newspaper, though eventually they start also accepting this newspaper. Okay, now we'll move to number two. Okay, number two newspaper. Now this says, now I'm not doing newspapers any particular order. It is just as in the any random manner, because when there is order, sometimes it's difficult to remember. The you'll after be, you know, that which came after which is never asked in your exam. Then came the your favorite newspaper. I know most of you people read this newspaper every day, and this is the Hindu. Okay, and and then there is one more newspaper. Actually, there are two which I'll like to talk to you in parallel. One is this Swadesh Mitran. Now, Swadesh Mitran was the newspaper. First, I'll talk to you about Swadesh Mitran. Swadesh Mitran was the newspaper which was started by the G. Subramaniam Iyer. And second person involved here was the Veera Raghavachari. We'll see later on how these two people are also involved in the formation of Madras Mahajan Sabha. Okay. Now, this is the first vernacular. This is the information actually I missed, so I would like to tell you that this Samachar Darpan, it was the first vernacular paper of India, and it was in Bengali anyway, right? Now, this is G.S.I.R. and Veera Raghavachari started this newspaper, and this newspaper was actually later on, these people, 4 years after the Swadesh Mitran started, they started the Hindu, which comes to our home every day nowadays, and then, you know, later on, this newspaper company is acquired by Kasturi Brothers, which are the present owners. And actually, the company was even liquidated. And so that is how the things are, right? So Kasturi Brothers own this company since 1915, right? Then there is another important newspaper, the name of which is Bengali. There is double E. Now, who is the person you think can own this paper? The person who can really own this paper is known as the Surendranath Banerjee. Surendranath Banerjee. Okay, so you will find you will observe that there are two E's over here in this, and there are two E's over here in Bengali. This is not B-A-N-G-A-L-I, this is double E. So this will make it easier for you to remember few things. So please, you can focus on it this way, right? Next is we'll move to the next one, right? And this is the rival of the Bengali newspaper. This is a very, very famous newspaper named after a village in Bengal. The name of the village is the Amrit Bazaar. And this name of the newspaper is the Amrit Bazaar Patrika. Okay. And who started this Amrit Bazaar Patrika? There were two main people. One is the Shishir Kumar Ghosh. And the second person over involved is the Motilal Ghosh. This name has been asked in paper few times, the Motilal Ghosh. Some of you might think this is not important, but it is important newspaper for us, okay? Now, this newspaper is a very complex history, because initially this newspaper started in Bengali, and then it also started producing Bengali and in English, and then there was Vernacular Press Act passed, there were restrictions on press was gagged, and then it turned overnight into only English newspaper. Under the Vernacular Press Act, all the local vernacular newspapers were only abolished, and not every newspaper was abolished, okay? So this is how it goes. Now that is Amrit Bazaar Patrika, right? And then there comes the number fifth newspaper, which is known as the Sudharak. Let me talk about it. Sudharak newspaper, this was started by Gokhale, there is nothing much in it, you can easily remember this, Sudharak, and focus is on the letter K, just in case, if you like visual, thing, which makes it easier to remember, I remember things this way, so visual things through K is common, you can see this, obviously there will be many other K's, but it is very prominent here. So Sudharak was by Gokhale, this is important. Then after Sudharak, I'd like to talk to you about a newspaper called Indian Mirror. Now this again has been asked in your examination twice, I believe already, the Indian Mirror. And who started this? This is started by Devendranath Tagore. Who's Devendranath Tagore? Devendranath Tagore is the middle son. The oldest is the Dwarka, then come Devinder, and then come Ravinder. So there is the DNT, Devendranath Tagore. And who's the second person involved by them? He is Manmohan Ghosh. Okay, Manmohan Ghosh. These are the people involved in it, right? Then we'll talk about number 7. After Indian Mirror will come Voice of India. See, this is where you can easily say that, sir, you could have given us list. Please don't ask me for that list because you will not remember this. My purpose is to help you remember things and not just give you a tsunami of facts. Okay. And then there are now we're going to talk about two articles over here, two newspapers, which are Voice of India, Rast Guftar. I hope by the time name Rast Guftar, you have already guessed it. That who started it, right? If you have thought about Naroji, then you should consider that you have a high chance of clearing this paper because you have listened to earlier lectures properly. Okay, so this Rast Guftar was the first newspaper of India in Gujarati language. Then after this came the two newspaper. One is the Hindustani. Okay, and then second one is the Advocate. Now these two newspapers were started by G.P. Varma. Now this is the toughest one I have found to remember, right? But you have to somehow remember it. This is G.P. Varma. Okay. Now after G.P. Varma, we will talk about a very famous newspaper. There are two newspapers actually. That's number 9, which is Tribune and Akhbar-e-Aam. Tribune is very popular newspaper and Akhbar-e-Aam, I don't know it is even if it exists today, okay, but then this was there, Akhbar-e-Aam. And this newspaper was started by a very rich person, his name was Dayal Singh Majithia, right? Now, this was in Punjab, of course, right? And then number 10 comes, and number 10 is little complex, actually. This is one of the most complex newspaper name that I had to remember. So, there were actually 4 or 5 newspapers started by this person. I'll tell you his name first. His name is the Brahm Bandhav Upadhyay, right? Brahm Bandhav Upadhyay. Right, and what he started many newspapers, many pamphlets, right? For example, newspaper was there Hindu Prakash, and then there was Dhyan Prakash, and then there was Kal, and then there was Gujarati and Sandhya. Therefore, a few of the newspapers started by Brahm Bandhav Upadhyay. Please do not get scared. I'm telling you, reminding you again. Don't worry. You will remember them. Spend some time with these people rather than spending time with anybody else. You will remember them. Okay. If you want to clear the paper, this will be ultimately come to you. Then there is a very famous newspaper, Bengal Gazette. Now, this is also the first newspaper of India, right? First, and this is actually the first newspaper of the English subcontinent, Indian subcontinent. First newspaper of English subcontinent. This is what the newspaper is. This is Bengal Gazette. And this Bengal Gazette newspaper, this was in English and this was started by James Augustus Hickey. Hickey. Asana yaad karna hai. So it's very easy to remember this one. And he was also helped by an Indian whose name was Harish Chandra Ray. Right. So that's how this person is. And then, you know, I'll talk to you about, because I'm talking to you about Gazette, I'll talk to you about another newspaper called Indian Gazette, right? And this Bengal Gazette is started in Bengal and Indian Gazette is further east. Okay, this is started in basically, so that means there is another newspaper by the same person. It's called East Indian and it is started by Derozio. See, whenever you read anything about any person, you can always write about him. For example, Derozio. We all know that Derozio was inspired many revolutions of the world. And this is what he tried to do in India also. Okay. Then after this comes the favorite of everyone. He is known as the Mr. Raja Ram Mohan Roy. Now Mr. Roy created few newspapers. Actually, he created many. He was overeducated and he's created a lot of problem in this sphere for students. Anyway, that please don't take this seriously. Okay, now what he started, Raja Ram Mohan Roy, he started something called Sambad Kaumudi. Sambad Kaumudi. That was what he started by him. And then he also started the Miratul Akhbar. Miratul Akhbar. Right, that was also by Raja Ram Mohan Roy. And then this was the first Persian newspaper, Miratul Akhbar. First Persian. And then after that, Miratul Akhbar, he also started Bangdat. Banga Datta. And in the starting of this newspaper, there were two people involved. One was Raja Ram Mohan Roy and other was the Dwarkanath Tagore. Okay. So this is how the things were in newspaper. See, there are many newspaper, I understand. You have to write as many as you can in your mains paper. At least you should be writing 5 to 10 in your paper. And if you can remember any in the your for your prelim exam, as many as you can. If you can remember all, that will be very good for you. Okay. After this comes the Yugantar. It is very, very easy to remember Yugantar. Okay, here I'll write Yugantar. Okay. This Yugantar newspaper, it was, Yugantar, you must have heard of the singer Yo-Yo Honey Singh, and Yo-Yo, right, this Yo-Yo Boys are there, okay, so Yo-Yo Boys, just to remember him, why Yo-Yo Boys, because it was started by two people, one was the name of Barinder and one was Pupinder. Okay, so there were two people, Barinder Kumar Ghosh and other was Bhupendra Nath Datta. So Barinder Kumar Ghosh and Bhupendra Nath Datta. So these were the two names associated with him. And then, you know, the very easy newspaper is next one, which is known as the, it's called Indian Sociologist. I hope you know the name this already because it is very famous. It has, you must have done in some test series also. And please remember that Indian Sociologist newspaper was started in London. That is where something which most people don't know. But most people know that this newspaper was started by Shyamji Krishnaji Varma. Okay, now there was another newspaper which is called Gadar. Now Gadar, this kind of thing can happen only in Punjab, and that is done by Lala Hardayal. Okay, Lala Hardayal is there, right? And then there is a very, very important newspaper. This might be asked just in your exam this year also. This is known as the Reformer. And it was by Mr. Prasanna Kumar Tagore. Okay, Prasanna Kumar Tagore. See, if you are writing in your copy, you will remember it more with me. You have to be involved when you learn such a rote learning, because there cannot be much about all this. Most of the newspaper did the same work. Okay. And then there was another newspaper called Hindu Patriot. And this was started by Girish Chandra Ghosh. So this is pretty easy, Girish Chandra Ghosh newspaper, right? And after this, there comes another, we are still doing the newspapers only, right? It'll continue for at least 5 to 10 minutes more, right? Now, then comes the new newspaper called Leader. See, try to understand that all the leaders, they are the same. That means they're all, it is started by the person, the name, whose name, so, you know, all the word, they have the first letter same. Okay. If in English, that is called alliteration if you are interested, but there is no need of knowing the word alliteration for you otherwise as such. So this is known as the Madan Mohan Malviye. Madan Mohan Malviye, he started this Leader. Okay. And then, you know, if this also reminds me of another newspaper, it's called Prabhakar. By the very word itself, it seems like it will be a Marathi newspaper. So it is a Marathi newspaper, and it was started by Lok Hitwadi Gopal Hari Deshmukh. So who started it? Lok Hitwadi Gopal Hari Deshmukh. And actually, in this newspaper, he goes on to write some letters to write, and these letters are known as the Shatpatran. This might be asked in your paper. Most of the people will remember Prabhakar, Deshmukh, but not Shatpatran. Please do not make such a mistake. Okay, then there comes another newspaper which is called Bombay Gazette. And this is Bombay Pupinder. So this was Bombay Barkhudar. And this was started by Tarkadar. So it was started basically, his full name is the Shri Bhaskar Pandurang Tarkhadkar. Tarkhadkar. Okay. So his name is Bhaskar Pandurang Tarkadkar. That was by Bombay Gazette by this person. Okay. Now there are many, many more newspapers on this list. Only I'll let me talk to you about those newspapers. For example, there is a newspaper called Bahishkrit. These are very easy ones now. Bahishkrit, who started this newspaper? Very easy to say. It was started by Ambedkar. Okay, let's name him here now, Ambedkar. Then after that, there was another Jeevan by, this is known as the Bandi Jeevan. This was by Sachin Sanyal. Some of the newspapers should be in your memory very strictly. Please understand this list is enough for you, but try to remember as much as you can, right? National Herald, spend some time. You can reverse the lecture, listen to this part of the lecture again and again and again, or you can listen to this lecture as many times as you want so that you remember it, okay? National Herald, this is a very quite a big thing, and national level per only few people could think like that, and the person who did actually think about this was Jawaharlal Nehru, okay? And then there was some South Indian newspaper. Let me make my South Indian friends very happy. This is known as the Kudiyadasu, right? And this was also, I've already talked about this earlier also in one of the lectures. Anyway, this is started by E.V. Naikar, right? And then there is a newspaper called Bande Mataram. Who started this newspaper? Ba se matlab hota hai Bande. Bande means Bikaji. So this newspaper started by Bikaji Kama. Okay, I'll just change the color for you over here. This is Bande Mataram and this is the Bikaji Kama. So there are two B's over here. It is very easy to recognize this one. Then there was another newspaper which is with V, which is Bande Mataram. Bande Mataram nahi, it's Bande Mataram. And Bande Mataram newspaper was started by Shri Aurobindo Ghosh. Aurobindo Ghosh. Okay. And then there is another very, very famous newspaper, and that is known as the Common Wheel or Young India. Common Wheel, and then also Plus, actually there are two newspapers, and Young India. Just to differentiate it, I'm just drawing the line so that it doesn't trouble you much. So there is Common Wheel and Young India, and this was started by Auntie Basant, I mean Annie Basant. Annie Beasant, right? And then I'll give you a very small list of newspapers. He has started many, and most of them were very successful. Okay, who started Harijan? He's the same person who started Nav Jeevan. And he also started Young India. Can you name this person? His name is Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhi. Right. And there's more to it still to the newspapers. And for example, there is a newspaper called Comrade, and Comrade is quite simple. It started by Muhammad Ali. Okay. Then after Comrade, I'll talk to you. There was another, now I'm reminded just of Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan. Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan. Do you remember the newspaper he started, the pamphlet that he was publishing? It's known as let me just write it properly here. This is known as Tehzeeb Ul Akal. Okay, and then a very, very famous newspaper, Al Hilal. This has been asked in paper. Who started Al Hilal? Maulana Abul Kalam Azad started this newspaper, Al Hilal. Okay, and he also started another newspaper, Al Balagh. I would be thankful if anyone knows these languages and who can tell me the meaning of Al Bilal in comment section. Al Hilal and Al Balagh, right? That will be good to know. Then there is another book, right? M.G. Ranade writes this. Whenever Ranade writes this, he is going to write about economy mainly. So he goes and writes the essays in Indian economics. Essays in Indian economics. This is what he writes. Essays in Indian economics. Okay, and then there is finally, you know, at the end comes Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar. So what will he start? He'll start the Som Prakash. Prakash is a Hindi word which means light, right? So basically what is happening that this person is a Sagar. So there is a some Sagar over here. Okay, you can imagine this one, right? This is a Sagar. And then also there is a sun, right? Prakash, which is giving them the light, right? So there is light coming. So you can just remember this thing, that Som Prakash was started by Vidyasagar. Okay. So that is how the things are about the newspapers. And now before I move on to the next topic, I would like to talk to you about something more about the newspapers. And what is that thing? Let me tell you, because I have not covered, this is one topic which I have not covered in full detail earlier, right? So if I talk to you about the newspaper, they were started by for one of the earlier interest was taken by Raja Ram Mohan Roy in 1824 when he protested against the restrictions of the freedom of press that were imposed in 1813, right? And 1835 or 36 when Charles Metcalfe comes, these restrictions are removed. Charles Metcalfe, okay, you know this. And then, you know, national movement actually could not happen. You see, 1870 to 1918 are national movement. It was not a mass movement. Right, national movement was really not a mass movement. So there to get freedom, Indian national movement had to be a mass movement. So how did we made it mass movement? How did you make it? By politicization, right? This is where the role of Gandhi comes. Gandhi's biggest contribution is the making Indian national movement a mass movement, because without masses you cannot achieve freedom. Politicization is there and spread of political agenda. Gandhi was a master of writing. He knew the right skill of writing so well that he could, you know, provoke people to fight against Britishers. And then there was also education, educate people could be educated by newspaper. And then there finally, you know, there was one more important thing, that was that there had to be something called nationalist ideology. So there had to be formation of nationalist ideology, that how are we going to fight with Britishers, what are we going to do for it, okay? And for all these things, press was the main instrument for following these things, right? And in fact, Congress, which we'll see in the coming lectures, when the Congress is formed, one third of the work of the Congress is done through the press only, right? And you know, more than that actually, and major work. In fact, I wanted to tell you that one third of the founding father of the Congress in 1885, they were journalists only. So that thing becomes important, okay? About the press. Now there are a few more things about press. What was the influence of the press? That I'll talk about now. Influence of press. What kind of influence was it having? Was it just in towns or was it in wherever it was? So it was not confined to towns and cities. It was everywhere. So it was having pan India. In village, what will happen? One person will buy the newspaper and read it out to the whole village. How interesting that is. If one person comes and just tells me the whole newspaper of the day every day, so much time of mine will be saved. But there is no one doing that. Okay, now whosoever is doing that, I don't know, like you know, I refer to few, I won't take which one, right? Even I myself started, but that is very, very impractical, very difficult thing to do. So I'm looking for someone who's doing it properly, giving me complete picture of the newspapers, not just reading out the newspaper to me, right? So not confined to towns and not just confined to towns and cities, and it was not just confined to literate, as I just told you that it was even read to the illiterate people by the literate person. And because of the press movement only, that in India library movements were started. There were mobile libraries and vans full of books would go to village after village and would try to educate people, right? So around a single newspaper, you know, there was some news around a single newspaper, the whole library would be set up. That is how things went on, okay? And then, you know, every news was read and discussed. Trust me, all these people were same as IAS aspirants, because they had to read and also discuss the newspaper. Are not we doing the same thing, fighting for the freedom? Okay, now newspaper at that time, unlike today, see the Hindu, whatever its spirit might be, in North India, it cost 8 rupees. It's so damn expensive. That makes no sense. No other newspaper is so costly. This is in 2015, the price is going to increase after this. Okay, anyway, but at that time, newspapers, you know, those were not business enterprises. Hindus charging money even for online edition, right? How, who does that? Almost every newspaper is free online. How foolish of them. Anyway, so there was a like business enterprise, right? I hope they improve. This is the situation in up to June 2015. So the newspapers were not the business enterprises. In fact, they were for the national and public service. National and public service, undeniably Hindu has got some great content and they are doing a great national and public service, but then they are also a business enterprise that cannot be denied considering the price of their newspaper. Anyway, and you know, Surendranath Banerjee at that time, actually he was not the original founder of newspaper Bengali, he purchased the goodwill of Bengali, and that is how it started, right? So that is how what was the influence of press at that time. But what was the style of writing in these newspapers? So problem was actually section number 124A. That is why this section is this topic is important. A style of writing, that is. So there was sedition, okay. And since 1870, this law was there of sedition. And by this, if you wrote anything against the government, then you could be arrested, or your newspaper could be confiscated, your press machine could be confiscated. Okay, so that was the problem. But anyway, so to counter this problem, what happened, articles were written in a very different kind of language. For example, there was a lot of use of irony, there was sarcasm, there was mock seriousness. Okay, everything was used. There was mock seriousness, Britishers were made fun of. And in fact, Tilak was a master of this art. I have already talked to you. You know, he would speak as if he's a well-wisher of the government, but in reality he was criticizing government. That is how he would write. And then, you know, London, the extracts of newspapers from London, and then Irish newspaper, or extracts of whatever is happening there, the revolutionary ideas were published in all these newspapers. Okay, now before I move on to next topic, I will give you a very small introduction about the important phases of the newspapers. Phases of newspapers. Right, first phase is the 1870s phase, and this is the phase where, which is basically where the here Lytton was there, right? And Lytton was very inhumane in his approach to the famines of 1876 and 77. We know this, we have read this thing. Lytton, he behaved in a very wrong manner, right? And then there was in 1878 Vernacular Press Act. 1878 you had Vernacular Press Act. Okay, and it was directed only against the vernaculars. So this became a problem. If you wanted to gag the press, you could have, you know, asked to control all the newspapers. Okay, so that was the problem. So, you know, under this, there was confiscation of press, the printing machine, that is, okay, press. Then there was of paper, right, and other ink and all other material, right? And this was obviously vehemently opposed, and this was ultimately by Lord Ripon, Lytton Ripon, Bhai Bandhu, Dehi Katthe Milke, Ek Banayega, Dusra, one will bring the law, one will repeal the law. Lytton brings the law of Vernacular Press Act, Ripon repeals the law of Vernacular Press Act in 1881, right? And then actually when this act came, because of this act only, Amrit Bazar Patrika turned into purely English newspaper overnight. And then after there was another phase of newspaper. This is 1905 onward. This is the second phase. This was the first phase. Now is the second phase. In this second phase of newspaper, there was lot of mocking done, right? And this became more and more violent. So because ultimately again there is some restriction which is later on relieved. And they would even, you know, put jokes, right? They will pull the legs of the Britishers. For example, once, you know, there was a funny story actually that Lord Curzon was there, right? He say, you know, he gave a speech which was printed in Amrit Bazar Patrika, and he says, I'm not a real relative of a queen, but he's unmarried. Ki abhi meri shaadi nahi hui, to main banne ko to taiyar hu. So, you know, Indians had a good fun, right? So Indian fun was also associated with the such kind of movements only, right? So now that was all about the newspapers. Now I'll talk to you about something called, as I said in the beginning only, there was something called middle class consciousness, right? So this middle class consciousness, this was reflected in what is known as, you know, in the writings, okay? Right. So middle, this I talk to you about middle class consciousness only, all the newspapers, right? And the newspapers and writings and, you know, articles, okay, pamphlets. So I've already talked to you about this middle class consciousness. This was about whatever talk. But after this, because this was just not enough in itself, there was something more to be needed. And because press and public was not enough, so there were many associations formed. Okay. What are these associations? What were their role? Now I will talk to you. And ultimately, it is these associations. See, what is happening is these small associations are formed, and there comes the realization that we need some big organization, big association. These small associations will not solve our purpose. So what are the associations formed? Now I will talk to you about those associations. Okay, so let us start, right? What is happening? First of all, I will talk to you about something which is known as Bang Bhasha Prakashika Sabha. Prakashika Sabha. Okay. Now, this was started by Raja Ram Mohan Roy. Oh, by the way, do you know who wrote the biography of Raja Ram Mohan Roy? It was Mary Carpenter. Tarkhanthi, Carpenter, who wrote this. Okay. And then this was written in 1836 and it was in Bengal. See, all these associations were formed in various parts of the world actually. I'll talk to you about all those things, right? And Metcalf, as I told you earlier, was the main person, Governor General at this time, okay? So this is one, right? Bang Bhasha Prakashika Sabha, right? After this comes Zamindari Association. Zamindari Association. Please remember that all these associations are started by rich people only, the middle class people only, okay? And Zamindari Association, this was also known as Land Holders Society. Okay, now who started this? Lot of people, huge list, okay? One is the sabse purana Tagore, and that is Dwarkanath Tagore. Dwarkanath Tagore, DNT. Right, then other person was Prasan Kumar Tagore. So there were Tagores involved. Then there was Radhakant Dev involved. Radhakant Dev was there. And then one more person, his name is Ram Kamal Sen. This is a very different name in this context, which I always forget. I hope you remember this one. Ram Kamal Sen. Okay, now basically its name is very clear. Zamindari Association, Landholder Society. It will become over there to save the interest of the landholder. Okay, it will have a limited objective. It basically, and it will be peaceful. It will follow constitutional manners. For example, they would follow the law of the land, and accordingly they would appeal to the government, right? Now what happened, that these two, this Bang Bhasha Prakashika Sabha and Zamindari Association, they were merged into one organization, right? And this organization, actually not Bang Bhasha Prakashika, there is one more actually, okay? Not this one, right? Actually, there were two organizations which were merged to form British India Association. Okay, I'll talk to you about British India Association, but which were those two which were merged? One was Zamindari Association and other was the Bengal British India Society. Okay, I'll write its name. I hope there is no confusion. Bengal British India Society. Right, and this was started by Dwarkanath Tagore. Dwarkanath Tagore, right? And this was this one over here, it was in 1838 and this was in Bengal, and this is in 1843 and this is in Bengal, right? And this time Alan Brough was there, right? They would disseminate all the information about British India. They would make the government aware that this is happening, you are doing wrong. Actually, a lot of these people, in fact most of the people, felt that British rule is good for us, but what is happening that they are not realizing our condition, so they wanted to make Britishers aware of our condition. That is why so many associations are formed over here. Okay, by mixing number 2 + 3, these two organizations over here, okay, let me just change the color for you so that you remember this one, right? Now these two over here, right? These two are merged together to form a new organization which is called British Indian Society, right? British Indian Association, rather. British Indian Association. Okay, now this is formed in 1851 and this is also in Bengal. And what do they do is that they have a very all India outlook, okay? And they demand four things from the charter. Like, they demand that legislature should be popular in character. That means the members of the legislature should be chosen. Executive and judiciary should be separated, right? We have today executive and judiciary separated by our constitution itself. And then, you know, higher officers should be given less salary. Their salary should be reduced because it was very high. It was leading to drain of wealth theory and all that, okay? So, and then, you know, finally, there one of the demand was that two things should be reduced. Now, these are very, very clever people and very chalu people. What do? They demand reduction in salt tax. Okay, I understand that. But they also demand that abkari duty should be removed, okay? Abkari is basically the tax on wine, alcohol. So they want the abkari duty to be removed. Okay, and few of these demands were accepted in 1853 Charter Act later on, right? So these are the few of the Bengal only. I'm still talking about organizations of Bengal only. There was one more organization of Bengal. So there was one more organization of Bengal, right? So these one were there, right? And now, I'll have to draw the chart again, it seems. Yes. Right. So anyway, I'll just write it in this way directly only. So this is in Bengal, this is known as the Indian League. Very easy to remember, Indian League. Automatically from in my mind names come the Shishir Kumar Ghosh. We talked about the newspaper also by him. I hope you remember that. If you remember, thumbs up, please. Right, Shishir Kumar Ghosh. Okay, and you know, this was started, of course, in Bengal, right? And this again did the same work as other organizations were doing, right? Then there was another organization which is known as the Indian Association of Bengal, right? This has again been asked. This was not started by one people. This was started by a lot of young nationalists of Bengal. This is how this organization was there, okay? Then after that, in Bengal, there was one more which is very popular. This is known as the Indian Association. Indian Association, okay? So, see, there can be so much of confusion. I mean, this is some crazy stuff, man. For example, Indian League is there. Indian Association of Bengal is there. Now, only Indian Association is there. They don't have peace in their life. How will they have? They are not free, bhai. They are under Britishers. So, Surendranath Banerjee, Anand Mohan Bose, Dwarkanath Ganguly, these were the main people, right, who started this, this Indian Association, okay? And I would like to talk to you a few facts about this person called Surendranath Banerjee, okay? And this, let me tell you about Indian Association after that, okay? So, Surendranath Banerjee, this person, he was inspired by Young Italy movement, Mazzini, Garibaldi, okay? All those people. So, he was inspired by those people, Young Italy movement. Right, now this Indian Association, its first meeting was held in, why is this important, I'll tell you. First meeting was held in 1881, second meeting was held in 1883. Now, these meetings were held as a role model for the first meeting of the Indian National Congress in 1885. That is why this is important. Okay, now Surendranath Banerjee was a great leader, writer, orator. Achha bolta tha, achha likhta tha, achha leader tha. And you know, he was unjustly turned out of Indian civil services. Like a lot of people are done every day in India these days also. There is no transparency by UPSC or many other exam. You file RTI, they do not show your answer sheets. So that is unjust way of giving you the seat, right? And its aim was same as political education, unification of Indians on the common issues, okay? Such thing was there. But this also, this Indian Association, it failed to become an all India body. It failed to be an all India body. That was its problem, right? So we are done with the organizations in Bengal, right? Now I'll talk to you about the organizations in Bombay. And these are pretty easy ones, easier to remember. Pune Sarvajanik Sabha, very easy one, very easy. Okay, who started? This was by two people, M.G. Ranade and J.V. Joshi. M.G. Ranade, Justice Ranade and J.V. Joshi. Okay, and it's probably J only. No, it's G. Okay, G.V. Joshi. I remember it wrong. And this basically supported peasants, right? Pune Sarvajanik Sabha. Then there was Madras Mahajan Sabha. Now this Madras Mahajan Sabha, it was by lot of people. First, the two founders of Hindu, Veera Raghavachari and Subramaniam Iyer, those two people. Plus there was Anand Charlu, and then there was also Mudaliar. Okay, Mudaliar was also involved in this according to some sources that I have read, right? And this was obviously, right, this is just in 1884, this is just 1 year before the Congress. And then there is formation of Bombay Presidency. Bombay Presidency, it was started by Firoz Shah Mehta, K.T. Telang, okay, and Badruddin Tayyabji. So these are the people involved, 1885 and Bombay. And because these people are busy with this organization, many people are not able to take part in the INC first session, okay? And then there were few more organization of the Western India only, okay? This is number one, and this is number two, and number three. Let me write here only because a very small one. The first one is known as the Industrial, okay? This is for the right of labor, peasant, even the own factory owners. So Industrial Association of Western India, this was the name of organization, and Ranade started this organization. That was in 1890. Okay, and then there was one more association, and that is important because it was started by some very special person. This is known as the Bombay Association. Bombay Association, and it was started by Jagannath Shankar Sheth. Jagannath Shankar Sheth. And why is this person important? Because he contributed a lot of money to the Indian national movement, right? And because without money, how will you grow? So these things were there in Bombay. Now I will give you a quick review of what was happening in London also. Many associations were opened in London also. So the first organization that was opened there, it was known as the London Indian Society. What was its name? London Indian Society. Okay, this was number one. And this was this London Indian Society. It was started by Nauroji. And number two, the person who started it, it was Vomesh Chandra Banerjee, W.C. Banerjee. Alright, this movement over here, this was started in like a long time back, right? And in 1865 actually, right? And this is merged with the second movement, the second association that starts over there, which is known as the East India Association, okay? East India Association. I cannot write full word because of paucity of time, right? East India Association. And this East India Association, this thing merged into this one. It was started by Nauroji, and it was in 1866. Okay, Nauroji, do you remember one thing about Nauroji? He wrote this book, if you remember, the wants and means of India. Okay, the wants and means of India. Nauroji started wrote this book. I'll talk about Nauroji in a separate lecture. Wants and means of India. He wrote this book, right? He's also known as the father of modern politicians. Okay, father of modern politics, something like that, right? This person, I mean, East Indian Association. Now they would discuss all the questions in London only, okay, and later on they are launched in Indian cities also, right? And then after this, there comes a third organization which is also important, which is based in London only. This is known as the Indian Society. One was the London Indian Society. This is named as the just the Indian Society, right? And this Indian Society is started by Anand Mohan Bose, okay? Anand Mohan Bose. And so that is like pretty much about it. But then, you know, why, see, when I told you about all these things, something is in Bombay, something is in Bengal, something is in London. Now this shows that how the worldwide these organizations are spreading. But please try to understand that after we realized these were our reactions, okay? Just to sum it up, we realized that there was some national consciousness growing. We reacted. How did we react? By fighting Britishers. How did we fight? There were tribals fighting. There were so many. You can write anything. Civil rebellion were there. You can talk about those also. Why just tribals, okay? And then you can talk about newspapers and all. This is known as the medium, okay? Middle class consciousness was there. You can talk about them. And finally, you can talk about association also. And you can also talk about civil rebellion and all those things which were against the Britishers, right? So when all this happened, so there was felt a need of something bigger, something that could lead the whole of India. There was realization that now that, you know, we need something, we have to be united. See, all of us are having the same aim. We have to be united. So few people got together and they formed the Indian National Congress. So in the coming lecture, I will be talking to you about the Indian National Congress. So that is how it is. Okay. Now, before I end the lecture, I just have like one important request for you all. Like always. Okay. This is just a humble request. If you like this video, please share it with others, okay? When you share it, I know it, that things are moving good, okay? More the sharing, easier it is for me to make better lectures. You can also click on like if you don't want to share button, right? That will give me encouragement also. And then second thing is subscribe, right? If you want these videos in future to come directly into your email box, you can always subscribe to us. For subscription, you will have to click on this link over here, and then this will come as a mail in your box, all these videos, okay? So that was pretty much about it. Thank you so much for watching this.